whether you believe it or not, we need that power.
Yes, sir.
He's the only one that can see us through.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. This morning, our scripture is going to come from Psalms 121. And we're going to read the entire Psalms 121.
Yes, Lord.
And it says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hill from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. May the Lord add his blessings to the reading of his word. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, Lord Jesus, it's again that we come as humble and as meek as we know how. Lord God, we come calling on your holy and righteous name, Lord. Because, Lord, there's no other name under heaven that we can be called to be saved, to be healed, to be delivered, and to be set free. Lord, we ask that you come in, Lord. Work the miracles in our lives that you know we stand in need of. Lord, we ask that you bless from the smallest to the greatest. Lord, bless our pastor as he comes forth with the bread of life. Lord, we ask that you use him, Lord Jesus. And Lord, that he would feed your people. Lord, we ask that you bless each and every one that's under the sound of my voice. We realize we're living in a changing time. But Lord, you know all about it. Lord, we ask that you lead and guide us, Lord, in the way that you have us to go. Bless the sick, the shunning, the bereaved heart, and troubling mind everywhere. Lord God, have your way in this trying times. Bless each and every heart. Touch those that don't know you and depart to their sins. Lord, let them know that you, God, and beside thee, there's none other. And Lord, we pray that when we've done all evil sign our hands to do on this side, and we can no longer stand on this side, Lord, we pray that we may hear your welcoming voice saying, well done, thy good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. Come up a little higher and take your rest. Lord, these are all blessings we ask in Jesus' name. For Christ's sake, amen. grace of God.
Amen. We bless God for those of you that are listening to us today by Facebook and those that are on the conference line. We bless God for you today. Share, hit that share button. Amen. Like us if you wish to. Today you're going to find us in the book of Philippians chapter 1, verses 1 through 6. And we want to focus on verse 6. Amen. Philippians chapter 1, verses 1 through 6. And we find here in the Word of God, Paul and Timotheus, the servants of Jesus Christ, to all the saints in Christ Jesus, which are at Philippi, with the bishops and deacons, grace be unto you, and peace from God our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 3 says, I thank my God upon every remembrance of you, always in every prayer of mine for you, all making requests with joy for your fellowship in the gospel from the first day unto now. And this is the verse I would love to focus on, verse 6. Paul says to the Philippians church, being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Can I say it again? Paul says, being confident. Yeah. Paul was confident about this thing. Being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. If I use for a topic this morning, my topic simply says, let God finish what he started. Can I say it again? Let God finish what he started. I want you to know he can finish it, but you got to let God finish it. I want you to know he's able to finish it, but you got to let God finish what he started. I stop by to tell you, God is not a man that he should lie, neither is he the son of man that he needs to repent. If God said it, somebody shout, that settles it. If God has spoken it, shall he not make it good? I stop by to tell you, you ought to let God finish what he started. Let me talk to you today and bring you up to speed. Let me talk about Paul for a few minutes. Paul had three major missionary journeys. And in these journeys, in these missionary trips, Paul established many churches. Amen. The Bible lets us know that he had several companions with him many times. One time it was Barnabas and John Mark. Other time it was Silas, Timotheus, and Luke, and Epaphroditus. And they were there to help Paul go from city to city. Amen. Establishing churches. And the regions got farther and farther and farther away. In fact, the churches got so far spread apart until Paul could no longer visit the churches as he would want to. So many times Paul had to write letters, amen, to the various churches. And as a mother is to her children, so was Paul to the churches that God allowed him to birth through the power of the Holy Ghost. As a mother warns her children, as a father warns his children, Paul took the saints from these churches as his children. And many times, Paul warned them. Amen. I can remember Paul, even in chapter 4, he reminds the church of Philippians not to be anxious for nothing. He says, be careful for nothing. But he says, in everything, you need to pray with supplication and with thanksgiving, making your request known unto God. In other words, Paul reminded the church, if you're going to pray, don't worry. But if you're going to worry, you might as well stop praying. Right. But he says, in everything, make your unto God. And he said, the very God of peace will keep your heart. He will keep your mind. Paul, even in this chapter of Philippians, Paul warned them about potential trouble that was coming. Paul even taught them about humility. Paul told them, as Jesus humbled himself, left his throne in glory, and came to this mean world, we too must humble ourselves. Paul reminded them, it should never be about you, but it should always be about somebody else. You should always prefer one another. It's not about me. It's not about you, but it's about us building up the kingdom of God. Come on and give God some thanks. Come on and give God some praises. So if you allow me to bring you up to speed, the Bible says Paul was on his way to his second missionary journey. And Paul had in mind of visiting the churches that he had established in the first missionary journey. But how many know God can change your plans? How many know you might plan one thing, but God will change your plans? That's why it's good to be sensitive to the Spirit. And the Bible says the Lord stopped Paul and told Paul not to go to Asia. In fact, later on that night, Paul had what was called the Macedonia vision. He had a vision about a man in Macedonia. And in this vision, the man said, Paul, I need you to come over here and help us. Come on and give God some thanks. And the Bible says when Paul got up the next morning, Paul told his companion, we're going to Macedonia. I had a dream that a man needs us over there. Come on and say yeah. And the Bible says when he got to Macedonia, which is really a little town called Philippi. Philippi was a Roman colony in Europe, between Europe and Asia. But the Bible says when he got there, Paul found some women praying by the riverside. When I read that, I thought about the song, let's go down by the river. Let's go down by the river. Paul went by the river, and Paul found Lydia and some women praying by the river. In that town, there wasn't a synagogue. Come on and see it. But nothing should stop you. Believing is better. They believe on the word. woman received Christ. She and her whole house were saved. They were baptized. She and she loved Paul and his companions so much. She made them stay at her house. Revival is starting in Philippi. Come on and say yes. Thank you. getting to my point. But guess what? It's through EJ. I want you to know, sometimes God will bring trials. God will bring you a platform of trouble so he can show up. Show up and somebody shout, show up. See, yeah. The Bible says they threw EJ. But at midnight, I guess somebody shout, midnight. Paul and Silas begin to pray. One pray and one song. See, yeah. What do you do when you're locked?
Yeah.
church. This was a giving church. This church was used as a model to Corinthians, to Ephesians, and Galatians.
Repeated.
I look at you and I say, that's good, but let
said, I hear you when you say, I got baptized. Like the Bible says, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I'll look at you and I'll say, that's good. But let God. Somebody shout, let God. Let God. Finish it. Sing it. And say, that's good, but let God finish it. See, yeah, I come to tell you that I'm almost done. I come to tell you he begun. Listen to how I say it now. He begun a good work for you. I said he begun a good work for you.
Jesus says, now unto him
Oh, what am I going to do? Choose this now unto him. Open your mouth and say now. Or tell him who is able. Who is able. Now unto him. That is able. Now unto him. That is able. To keep me from falling.
There's somebody troubling their spirit. There's somebody the enemy's trying to turn around, throwing stumbling blocks in their way for them to give up. But I hear you telling me to tell them, he that hath begun this good work, like you did for the church on the earth, like you did for the church at Philippi, he that has begun this good work in you is able to complete it till the day Jesus returns. We love you. Those that are not saved among us,
We pray that a revival break out in our church, in our city, in our state, in our community, in our entire country, all over this world, so that souls will get saved. Cry out, I yield, can't hold out no longer. Save them before it's everlasting too late. That son, that daughter that we're praying for, that man, that woman, that boy, that girl that we're praying for, save them, sanctify them. Don't let them die and go to hell. Come on and give God your best praise as the choir gives us one final song before our benediction. Come on and give God your best praise. Let me see you praise Him. Let me hear you give Him your thanks.
not another day. Live this way. Somebody shout, I want to be changed. Lord, Savior, God, we thank you for grace. God, we thank you for mercy. We thank you for meeting us here. We thank you for feeling your presence. We thank you for making yourself known. God, we ask that you send out a revival. Change hearts. Change minds. Save souls. Let them cry out, not another day. Live in this way. I want to change. Let them cry out, like the song said earlier. God, take your place. I need you to take your place. Let all the other names fade away. Let all the other names fade away. Oh, God, take your place. Give God life. Have your way. When you do it, we'll give you glory. When you do it, we'll give you praise. May the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us.